2 weeks ago, there was a news that an app took over TikTok. And I was very shocked, and also I was very happy because it took over something nonsense, a very popular nonsense. And that app, if you have not yet guessed, is the Zoom video conferencing app. I've made 2 different videos on this particular app, one explaining you why it might be a potential threat, another one, the alternatives of the Zoom app. Links are given down below the like button. Check it out. So in this video, we'll see the top tricks of the Zoom app. Without any further ado, let's get started. The Zoom video conferencing app has become the wildly popular host to millions of people working and studying from home during this lockdown. So, starting off with the video with the first tip, that is to change the background of the host or the presenter. You should use the app, by the way. So just go to settings, and under settings you'll get this option called as virtual background. Once you're set up with the green screen behind you, you'll be able to change the background very easily in the app itself. So you don't have to make other arrangements for the presentation. Now the next thing is to mute the audio as well as the camera as soon as you get into the video. In order to do this, just go to settings and under audio, mute microphone when joining a meeting. Just check that box, and also go to settings again. In the video settings, check this box called turn off my video when joining a meeting. So that's it. And while talking, you'll have to search for the mic when your name is called. Instead of doing that, just press the space bar and it will automatically turn on the mic. And again, if you hit the space bar, it will automatically unmute the microphone. And also you can react with emojis on screen instead of turning on your mic always and also interrupting other people. So just for that, you can just use the emojis on the screen like thumbs up or clapping. And also you can change the color of the emojis from yellow to black or white or whichever the options are available. And also there are some handy keyboard shortcuts that I'll be telling at the end of this video. So stay tuned for that. The next thing is called the gallery view, where you can turn on the gallery view of all the participants that are there. If there are almost like 49 to 50 participants, you can see all of their screens in one single window. So to do that, whenever you see the person speaking, you'll be getting a tab that says gallery view in the top right corner. If you click on that, you'll be able to see all those 49 people. And another thing is just go to settings and under video meetings, you need to check this box called hide non-video participants. So whenever people turn off their video and just talk using the microphone, you can actually block them. Next thing is screen share, which is very popular in Zoom app. I hope all of you know about it. So using the screen share, you can present many things, the YouTube videos, you can show it to them directly or whatever that is displayed on your screen. Now you can do another thing, because since we are all at home, nobody wants to bat daily or nobody wants to get ready for a single video call. So what you can do is turn on this feature called beauty filter. It works similar to the phone's selfie camera that has the beauty mode. Usually Oppo and Vivo have those very strange beauty modes. So it works in the same fashion and you can make proper use of it. Now next thing you can do is record the meeting when you're on your computer, so the host can directly record the video that is being presented. So to do it, you can select many different ways, that is to get the links to the Google Drive or just Dropbox, or you can also save it to your file storage, the computer storage itself. So to do that, and under recording, just select this location where you want to store the video files and check the box called record video during screen sharing and all other boxes that you want. You can also record the meeting directly to the Zoom cloud, but you have to pay $15 a month for that. And you can also host a video call for more than 40 minutes and for more than 100 people. So to do that, you need to have this Enterprise Plus account. So you have to pay extra for the Zoom company. Now here are some shortcuts that I want to tell, the keyboard shortcuts. So I can't mention all of those, so I'll leave all of them in the description down below, so please do check it out. Some of them are like navigate amongst the Zoom pop-up windows, press F6, or also you can always switch the speaker view, that is for Alt F1 and Alt F2 for switch to gallery view directly instead of going to the top right corner of your screen. or also close current window at Alt+F4 that you already know, and start or stop a video just by clicking Alt+V. So there are many other options in the Zoom app, so I'll be dropping all of them in the description down below, so please do check it. So that was pretty much everything about the top tricks of the Zoom app. I hope you guys liked it. If yes, please hit that subscribe button, it really means a lot to me. With that being said, my name is Rahul and I am signing out. Take care, guys.